Good morning, my YouTube family. I know I look a little crazy right now, excuse that, but I definitely wanted to come and make a video. It has been a while since I've last recorded, a couple of weeks. Where do I start? I don't really know where to start, and if I'm looking over here, excuse that, I'm actually cooking some fried rice. I'm going to have some fried rice, egg, salmon, and then I'm going to have some avocado on the side, and then I'm going to drench that mofo with some sriracha. Fire. You know, you can do really anything with your leftovers. Just be creative, you know. But back to what I was saying, though, a lot has been going on. Life has been good though. You know, I've been having my fair share of ups and downs. As this new year, you know, progresses, however, and as the days go by. However, I've also had my fair share of highs. So I believe the highs definitely outweigh the lows, because if it was just lows, it would be definitely tough to bounce back from that. But let me turn the lighting up on this. One second. I don't have it on my tripod. Okay, that might actually work. But yeah, so, you know, I really don't know where to start, but I guess we'll start with the most exciting thing that happened. So, about going on 2 weeks ago, I went to Miami, and wow, all I can say is you guys don't even want to know the half about that trip. Although perhaps the ending of the trip was the most enjoyable, all in all, shit was crazy. But you know, we have to live and learn, and sometimes those lessons come off rather harsh. You know, sometimes those lessons are not meant to harm us, but they're just meant to propel us and prepare us for what's in store for us. But we can't keep on doing the same things that got us into trouble the first time, if that makes sense. But that's a process. You know, that's not something that we can just do overnight. We can set the intention all we want. We can hope, dream, and pray about it all we want. But the reality is, it's going to take steps to reach that point. You know, so although, like I said, some crappy things occurred while I was on my trip, I still made the best of it. I actually wound up meeting some really, really like-minded individuals. And I kind of launched something that I've been wanting to do, but I've just kind of been like, I don't know, in my mind I would just say, well, if I do this, what are people gonna think? Like, if I do this, people are gonna look at me this way or that way. But it's like, I came to the conclusion that I can no longer live my life like that. That's damaging me. That's harming me. Constantly worrying about what someone is going to think. You know, and I'm just at a place now where it's like, I don't give a damn what anyone thinks. You can think what you want. Your thoughts, excuse me, or opinions aren't fact. So, until you have cold, hard facts and truth behind any type of bullshit you're trying to spew or speak, back it up. Have some receipts. And even if you were lucky enough to have that, still, who are you? Like, who would you think you are to sit there and try to, like, judge somebody, you know? And that's kind of something that I've been dealing with everything that I've been doing. I've just kind of been going into it, like, with a grain of salt and tough skin. But yeah, so certain things aren't for everybody. That's one thing I can say, just based off of experience and observation. And with that being said, aside from, you know, the trip from Miami, you know, it was good. I met some really cool people, connected with a bunch of people since now being home. But now it's like having to face, I don't want to call it inner turmoil, because really anything can be reversed. And well, in certain senses of the word, you know, I guess where it's practical, it can be reversed, if that makes more sense. But really, all I'm just trying to say is, like, you know, circumstances change. Like, you know, certain things don't last forever. And as you all know, from my last video, you know, I'm currently not working. And truth be told, I really don't have the desire to go out and call myself trying to get a job, slave for a wage that is not even gonna get me through the month, slave to pay bills. No, you know, so I've been doing research, you know, I've been taking notes, I've been reflecting, and during these times, like, I need to be by myself. And I just feel like, you know, when you're trying to venture off and you're trying to separate and create a space for you and things like that, that way you can allow it some time to grow. And I just feel like in something like that takes, you know, I need space. And certain individuals in my life don't really get that. It's not that I'm... And really... And furthermore, truthfully, I don't really have to even explain why the fuck I need space. I don't. I don't have to explain why I don't fucking feel like talking today. I don't fucking feel like talking tomorrow. I'm so focused and I'm stuck in this tunnel vision mode right now where I'm just like, what I'm focused on is what I'm focused on. I'm not trying to revert my thinking to something that's going to distract me, take time away from something that I'm in the process essentially in building. And, you know, that's just not something I am going to risk at this time. Especially when the stakes are high, the demand is there. And so I'm thinking business-like, you know. So I just feel like a lot of people who have never owned a business or aspire to own a business or have had a business, regardless of what that business was, I don't give a damn if you had a candy bar business. The reason I say that is because my daughter, yesterday, we were talking and she's like, well, you know, I don't want to work when I grow up. And so in conversations like that, I try to, okay, turn it around and say, all right, well, I asked her, are you going to have your own business? Are you going to be a businesswoman then? What is your plan? You know, and she's like, well, I want to have a candy bar business. And then she just starts naming off all of these businesses. So just, you know, using that as an example, I don't give a goddamn if you have a candy bar business, if you have you sell fucking oranges, avocados, I don't care what it is. If you were your own boss today in this present moment, that is the wave. And it is never going to be the same again. Why do you think there's all these jobs from home all of a sudden? Now, perhaps if I could maybe find something from home part-time that paid a decent wage that I could just do part-time, perhaps. I'm not too opposed to that. But ultimately, this year, whatever it takes, how much time, money, effort, determination, will, whatever, resilience, I don't give a damn what it takes. I am going to be my own boss. You know, I never felt like when I had jobs and I worked for people, I never really felt like I honestly really mattered. I never really felt like my existence or me being employed at their company, I never really felt like that meant anything, you know? Sorry guys, this lighting. Just have to hold it. But yeah, I never really felt like I meant anything. You know, I didn't feel like I was going anywhere. I just felt like I do not want to fucking do this until I'm fucking 60 years old or whatever the fucking case is and rely on some fucking retirement or social security that right now, with the way things are going, isn't even fucking promised. So I've just been doing a lot of reflecting, you guys. I really, really miss. I miss you guys. I miss making videos. Excuse my freaking nozzle on my shower head broke. I still have running water. I just don't have hot water. So I'm waiting on maintenance to come and fix it because I need to scrub this face. But for now, one of those makeup remover wipes will do. But yeah, you guys, I was just really inspired, whether I look a mess or not. I was very inspired to do this video and just get this message out. I really and truly was. I came up like earlier today when I was reflecting, a quote came into my mind that I came up with, and it was, think like them, but be less sinister. I'll say it one more time. Think like them, but be less sinister. And a lot of just after I thought that, then my mind just started like exploring what I had just thought. Like, you know, I don't know if anyone else does that. Hold on one second, you guys. I don't know if anyone else does that. Like, you know, you'll be meditating in deep thought, reflection, whatever you want to call it, and a thought will come to your mind. So then you start digging deeper into that thought because now you're like, why did this just pop up into my mama? Why did this just pop up into my mind? Why am I thinking this? You know? And yeah, you guys. I was like, whoa. So I went deep down the rabbit hole. Not deep down it, but I went deep. Let's just say that. I should have did this before I got on camera. I'm sorry, you guys. But hey, I'm doing it now. Alrighty. Aside from my craziness, I may have a story time coming. I think it's just due because during this time, when I was in Miami, when this situation was going on, I did not have, like, I had somebody that I could talk to, but this particular person isn't someone that, it's just really not a like-minded individual. So I was quite lost and I was in despair. when I was out there. I was like, I could freaking potentially get stuck out here because I was freaking naive into believing this person was who they portrayed themselves as. And here I am fucking, oh yeah, you guys, I'm gonna do a story time on that. That's what I'm gonna do. Because the shit was wild as hell, you guys. Like, no fucking bullshit. It was so, like, wild. But I was saved by grace. And that's how I met one of the individuals that I am now doing business with. So yeah. Life is a freaking movie. Life is a movie. I'm telling you. If we aren't vigilant, if we don't act in discernment or use our discernment, these motherfuckers out here will fuck us up. I'm dead ass. They will fuck our whole lives up. But thankfully, some way, somehow, even though I do stupid shit, I swear to you, I may have to suffer for but a while, but some way, somehow, I've always saved. Like, somebody is always put into my path to assist me. To assist me in any way. You know. And or just pretty much there to get me out of whatever fucked up position I found myself in. You know. You know, life is a learning process. You know, I'm learning every day. Like, I'm not a perfect individual. I still make silly mistakes, even with all that I know. You know, but I'm human. That's really all I can be, is human. So, yeah. That, y'all, it was fucking cool. Crazy as hell. I was like, man, God, get me out of this one. Because I messed up big time. Aside from all that, though, I hope all of you...
Hey, y'all, I'm back. Sorry, I got a call. It's like every time I'm doing something, somebody wants to call me. Eat my breakfast. I made salmon, rice, and vegetables last night, and my daughter, with her picky behind, I guess she think, y'all, that money grow on trees, and that she just living it up in Bel Air somewhere, because that child, y'all, picky as can be.
Ooh, I don't like that. I don't like that.
I was like, girl, you didn't want to trade my childhood. So. Anyway, so good. I got some salmon, avocado, and rice and egg with green onions and onion. Drench it with some sriracha, ginger. This should do me good, you know. I just wanted to eat something like with a lot of protein, something hearty. I've actually been losing a lot of weight, you guys. Surprisingly. Well, not surprisingly, but I think I am pretty active. I'm not like very active, but I am for the most part active. Y'all gotta try this. This is so good. Mm. Yes, but aside from everything else, you guys, I also just wanted to send a, I don't know what I want to call it, I guess a safety message or a vigilance message. Just definitely stay alert and aware at all times with all this crazy ass bullshit going on in the world right now. It's like, goddamn, you know, if you think about it, it just seems like we're living this fucking movie or something. Like, it's like we're in some type of fucking movie that's like never ending or some shit, or I don't know what you want to call it, but this shit right here, bro, ain't it. Oh, everything it ain't. You know, this shit right here is just crazy. It's so damn crazy. Like, last year, I'm gonna be honest with you, when all this, I don't even know what to call it. I don't know if YouTube is censoring. Well, I do know that they are censoring shit, so can I say COVID-19 in the video? But when all that shit came about, I was like, whatever, man. But I did not foresee it to have turned into something globally as it has. And just, it's like this widespread sensation, you know? Really crazy if you ask me. All in all, I'm just trying to find ways to stay busy. Ways to create residual income. I am also in the process of finding like a financial literacy counselor, or what would that be, like an account, not an accountant, but I can't think of the word right now, but what their title is. However, your girl, I can't, like, when I just think of all of the money that I've touched since living, being on my own and everything like that, I'm like, girl, I could have done something with that. But I also try not to live in that mindset of, well, if you would have did this, or if you could have did that and should have did that, like, because that really gets you nowhere. All you have to do, and this is for myself included, is you just have to understand what your bad habits are. You have to understand what your just useless spending habits are, and discipline yourself and break those, you know, break those habits, especially when it condones your money. Like, yeah, that's important. You know, most Americans don't have an emergency savings of $500, and I don't want to be like that, you know, from this day forward, at least. You know, I always want to have just, like, this year is the year to build those multiple streams of income. And regardless of how long certain things take to really blow up and take the desired effect or take off the way you see it taking off. Yeah, shit like that does take time. But then there's also shit moments like all it takes is just, you know, getting around to, like, the right people, or, you know, all it takes is just one good fucking just shot, you know? And I'm not saying, oh, give me a chance, because I'm going to create that chance for myself. I'm going to create my own break. I don't need nobody giving me a break or giving me a shot, because I got what it takes. So, therefore, I have what it takes within to get there, you know? But, like I said, I've just been doing a lot of studying. My journal, I'm pretty much about to run out of pages. I've just been studying a lot. You know, another one of my big goals this year is, you know, definitely to travel. I have the goals and aspirations to travel to either Jamaica or Puerto Rico for my birthday, which is in July. And I feel as though if I keep at what I'm doing, at the pace that I'm doing it at, maybe amp it up here and there, but create different marketing strategies to reach certain audiences that I really feel that my content pertains to. And so I've just been working on developing new strategies. It's gonna get real this year. It's already gotten real already. So now it's just time to just focus, you know. I don't want to lose focus. I don't isolate myself in a negative way. I just feel like my energy does not mesh well with a lot of other people's energies in my life. And in order to protect my energy, in order to protect my space and my mental health, my mental clarity, I just stay away from people. I distance myself. Like, I can love you from a distance. You know, if I'm feeling upbeat or whatever the case is, maybe I'll check in with you. Maybe I'll feel like talking to you or something like that. But I've always been a lone wolf my entire life. Like, I've been a lone wolf. And I know that if nobody else in this life has me, I have me. I'm stuck with me until the day I leave this earth. You know, so I think that's important for all of us to know. There's nothing wrong with embracing your individuality, which is what I am now embracing. I always felt like I was different. I just always felt like I was different from everyone. I could never really connect with anyone except from, you know, from my childhood best friend Chanel, who, you know, passed away. I definitely could connect with her. You know, our spirits mesh well together. Like, that was like the only one and true friend that I've ever had in my life thus far. I have not met anybody that, you know, and it's not even about what a person can do for you either, because I don't look at friendships like that. Yes, it's a team effort and, you know, you're supposed to support each other and things like that, but it's not physically about what a person can do for you, but just the fact that, like, just her presence alone, you know, the way she embraced me, you know, that's something that I don't know if I'll ever be able to duplicate on this planet Earth again. Like, I used to tell everyone she was my sister because she was definitely like a sister to me. I talked to her about everything. We would talk, you know. I miss her so much. I really do. You know, and I just feel like now, the way this world is going, it just makes you just really want to be by yourself. It just makes you want to just shut everyone out sometimes, because who can you trust? Who can you lean on? Who can you really confide in? I'm not saying everybody is bad, but shit, a large portion of this fucking universe is bad, you know? And I don't know. I know I shouldn't close off completely, because maybe I would miss out on meeting that individual that I see. What I see in myself is what I want to see in someone else. You know, I'm not going to mesh well with someone who either does things that I'm not into, treats people the way that I can't, you know, treat others like. And, you know, it goes deeper, you know. And like I said, I've always been a lone wolf. And so I sometimes feel offended, because when you put that boundary up and you pretty much tell a person, like, hey, you know, I need some space, I need some time, I'm working on me right now, you know, whatever it is that I'm going through, I am going to figure it out, because no, I do not feel comfortable with being 100% vulnerable with anyone. You know, because some way, somehow, it'll come up and be used as a method or a tool to try to you know, come back with some sort of negativity later on down the road. And I can't deal with that either. I mean, it's, I'm not going to say like, oh, it's just going to bother me to the point where I'm just depleted and I'm just broken and I just can't go on. No, that's not the case. It's just, I choose not to be around people like that. If you're going to fucking drain my energy, if I feel any type of negative anything oozing from your spirit, I'm not going to fuck with you, like, at all. I just can't fuck with people like that, you know. It really messes me up. That's why right now I prefer just being single. I'm not opposed to casually dating. I'm 25, still in my 20s. You know, I do want to explore. I want to travel this world. I want to try new things, you know, indulge in new foods and just learn as much as possible about this place, this planet that we're currently living on. And I want to also learn as much about myself as possible too. I'd like to open up and dive deeper into that unknown that we all somehow fear. You know, I'm only me. That's all I can be. But I'm gonna end this here, you guys. I'm gonna go ahead and edit this video so I can get it up pronto. I do hope you all are doing well. Definitely just stay safe, sound, alert, healthy. You know, and like I said, I hope you guys can take something from this video. You know, it's time that we tap into our power, tap into our true selves, and understand that truly, despite the oppression, despite the division, despite whatever you want to call it, we still have the power within us to make our lives as magical and amazing, prosperous, and successful as we want. You know, that's why I said, think like them, just to be less sinister. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I do definitely appreciate the support. I think I finally made it to 100 subscribers, so thank you guys very much for that. That's definitely a milestone. I look forward to continuously growing with you guys. And again, if you guys have any type of video suggestions or anything like that, be sure to hit the comments down below and let me know. But until my next video, you guys stay safe, sound, and healthy. Checking out.